Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from whenever you're watching this channel, depending on the time zone. Now, the Baranaka Day celebration will take place in Bungoma County at Masinde Muliro Stadium. Preparation has been going on, but yesterday William Ruto decided to go earlier to Bungoma. He has a 3 days tour, what is referred to as working tour, though we understand it is campaign tour to Bungoma. So literally what Ruto took to Bungoma is tumepanga, tumetenga politics, period. That is it. But there are issues emerging out after Ruto landing in Bungoma. First thing, Ruto was not accompanied by his deputy Rigathi Gachagua. Gachagua is missing. He might join him today or tomorrow on the very day of Madaraka Day celebration. So, besides Gachagua missing, there is something Ruto said while in Bungoma, which seems to be a contradiction of what Gachagua said while he was in Rift Valley, to be specific, Kese's constituency. Ruto is asking politicians to come together, to do away with the politics of tribalism, to unite and make Kenyans or everyone in this country to feel free to move to Bungoma, Nyeri, Eldoret, and elsewhere. Freedom of movement. Feel free as a Kenyan. And then he want to achieve this by bringing leaders together. Viongozi wakuja pamoja, watu wakubwa. Wakubwa wakuja pamoja na wafanya Kenya ikue inchi ya kila mtu, utembee kila mahali freely. That was William Ruto.
Lakini tumelete hiyo function hapa kwa sababu tunataka kuweka Kenya pamoja. Tunataka wale wa kutoka Mombasa wakuje hapa waone kuna Bungoma na ni Kenya na kuna Wakenya na ni watu wazuri. Si ndio? Nyinyi pia mtoke huku, muende Nyeri, muende Eldoret, muende Kwale, mjue kuna Wakenya huko na ni watu wazuri. Ndio tuweze kujenga taifa moja ya Wakenya wote.
Now, Ruto's statement in Bungoma is coming after Gachagua. Some time back, he issued a standing warning to members of parliament while in Kese's. He was clear that wabunge wakae constituencies wafanye kazi huko. What is your interest in moving into other constituencies? That's where the problem comes in. So, mkae kwenu, kwa constituency yako fanya kazi. That was Gachagua. So you look at that, then you look at what Ruto is saying. You see a total contradiction. Now, there are two things that I want us to look into in this discussion. Ruto is preaching unity and against tribalism. Then Gachagua's position. We have to look into these two issues very clear and then give our views on the same, because Kenyans should also know the truth. But before we go deep into that, just a quick request. For those who are watching and you are not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing. To our returning subscribers, Samasa, thank you so much. And again to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Now, of course, when Gachagua was asking members of parliament to stay in their constituency, definitely it is a kind of preaching tribalism. That kaa kwenye stabe wengine. The reason was that members of parliament from Rift Valley are going to find people in Mount Kenya. So kiambia mbunge wa Rift Valley, a college, asiende Mount Kenya kwa Wakikuyu. Definitely, that's what we're trying to do. But above all, let us look clear into Ruto's statement. The issue of tribalism. Ruto is saying that we have to preach unity. That we bring people together, and a Kenyan can move from coast region. You go to Bungoma, you are okay. You go to Nyeri, you are okay. You go to Eldoret, you are okay. That is true. But is Ruto walking the talk? We start from there. Because he is addressing us from Western Bungoma. Is what Ruto is saying true? Is he truthful? Is he putting in action? And how is he doing so? Those are the questions. Because for us to believe Ruto's statement, for us to have an iota of trust in his statement, we have to see all this that he's talking about reflecting in his government. Starting from appointments, to Anzi Apu. Did he recognize that we have tribes in this country, and these tribes have been recognized in our constitution, whereby they say that when you are appointing people to a position of power and leadership, you have to consider our tribes? Go and check his cabinet. Is what he's telling people of Bungoma reflecting in his cabinet? Go and check on parastatals. Is what he's preaching in Bungoma reflecting in the appointment he did to parastatals? Just go and check PSS. Is it reflecting really what he says and what he has done? You go and check on all appointments. Largely, it is challenging. That is tribalism, pure tribalism. They even goes down to nepotism. Not all college in the benefits. There are few with connections here and there, family and all those. Then you go to Mount Kenya, because of politics also, a big chunk. So it is a Mount Kenya Rift Valley government. Okiongozwa na Rift Valley. That is not the face of Kenya. Luyas comes number two after Kikuyu, according to 2019 census results. So, for us to believe anything in Ruto's statement, number one, we should see majority coming from Rift Valley, Mount Kenya region. The appointment here in the Mount Kenya, Wakuwe ni wengi. Number two, in a form of photo na Western region, Waluya. Number three, the number of appointments Ruto did in his administration from appointing people from Rift Valley should be equal in the number from Nyanza region, because the 2019 census result shows us that Rift Valley and Nyanza region, they closely pair in terms of population. So, tukiangalia number of CSS and the PSS that have come from Rift Valley, are they equal in number to those that come from Nyanza region? Because they are equal in numbers. It's not true. After that, there's a problem. What about the campus? What about Lower Eastern, the Somali community here in Kenya? What about the rest? So, that's why I said in the beginning that Ruto just took to Pange to take his Pange and Tenga politics to Bungoma. Kazi kubwa ameenda kufanya ni kupanga na kunini, kutenga. But he does not walk the talk. So after there, we dismiss Ruto's statement. This is just pure politics. It is just political statement that has no any reflection in his administration. The most tribal person in this country is William Ruto and Gachagua. These two are so tribalistic. Gachagua anajivunia watu wametanguliwa Mount Kenya, na yeye ni deputy president wa Kenya, sio Mount Kenya. Hajivunia kwamba serikali yao it is carrying the face of Kenya. Anajivunia serikali yao it is carrying the face of Mount Kenya. Most tribal individual. Ruto, the appointing person. There is no balance in the government. So, his gospel of unity is a truthful gospel. What wa Bungoma don't clap for Ruto. Understand this man and question him. When he tells us about doing away with tribalism and then, you know, feeling free to be in Kenya. Let us also see that reflecting in his cabinet. It's not. Now, let us come to the issue of Gachagua. Gachagua alisema wabunge wakae kwao. Ruto is saying no. Ruto is contradicting Gachagua. So, definitely, for the first time, openly, Ruto chose Bungoma event to use it to respond to his deputy regarding Gachagua. And he has done so very clear, indirectly. Kama Gachagua elewe, akuja hapa asikize hii. When they say that You should feel free to move from God's region. You come to Bungoma and feel that Bungoma is home. Bungoma is Kenya. You can move to Nyeri, feel the same. You go to Eldoret, you feel Eldoret. It's home. Gachagua said, stay to your constituency and work from there. It's a contradiction to what Ruto is now telling us. Definitely politics at play, and cleverly, Ruto avoided going with Gachagua to Bungoma. The meaning of that? There is a rift in a UDA. It is clear these people are in war, and for Gachagua, it is too quick. At least Ruto managed to play it long under Uhuru Kenyatta. It only came out clear in the second term. But for Gachagua, in the first time, things are going opposite.